My name's Clive Cholerton. I'm the artistic director here at Caldwell Theatre Company.
And I'm Tim Bennett, and I'm the scenic designer for After the Revolution at Caldwell.
The history of the production is, this was a play that came into my world. I knew about it when it was being done at Playwrights Horizon in New York, and that was after its original production or workshop production at the Williamsburg Theater Festival. So, Williamstown Theater Festival, excuse me. So it was done at Playwrights to a great amount of acclaim. It made the New York Times top 10 plays of 2010, and then was also named in the anthology of best plays of 2010 for New York. So I had found out about it and asked to read a copy of the script and instantly fell in love with the story of typically, anytime we can find something that has a historical resonance to it, which obviously this play has got in droves, that interested me. And then the other thing that ultimately really grabbed me is that it's very much a play about family and about how the generations of a family view the same topic and how the way we view it is skewed very much by history and looking back on it and how that changes our opinions and our thoughts on it. And so it was all those things combined. I said this would be a perfect show to do here at Caldwell Theatre. Well, it's both. It's ultimately what the drama in it is about whether a family can reconcile their politics. So ultimately, it's about both. But at the end of the day, it really comes down to whether a father and a daughter can reconcile their differences and still respect one another and still be able to have a relationship moving forward.
Well, in discussions originally with Margaret Ledford, our wonderful director for this show, we just tried to decide what is this show all about. And we decided that truly, that when it comes down to it, yes, there's politics, but it is about family, which we keep hearing over and over. You heard that with the interview with the other actors in the show and from Clive. But the show, like so many new shows, moves from time, or you know, place to place to place very quickly, and we felt that this was not a show where we could be changing furniture for each scene because it would slow down the production and so on. So what we've created here is an environment, and I tried to give the feeling of family. I've put a family tree, a feeling in the back, but also with the political thread running through it, and sort of a home. And then we move the scenes from section to section of the stage, creating you know, the various family units in their various places, but all in this unit set. That's the magic of theater. no, actually, as always, we have to do everything on a budget. And this sofa we're sitting on was my really most expensive theater furniture purchase for this show. I found it at a thrift shop and talked them down from $50 to $11.93 after discounts.
So we're immortalizing how cheap we are. Yes, that's essentially what we're doing. That's nice.
And yes. Some of the chairs come from Clive's old office, and then we've had some things in stock. and so it's putting it together and making it look expensive. Well, the photographs are actually photographs of the cast that I've put together. You know, in family groupings, according to the way they are in the script, to kind of create my family tree. There is a set of photos there where we don't see one of the brothers' family. He references his wife and children, and so we've photoshopped his face into an appropriate family that I found, and so on. But that's the whole idea of the posters and the family, is to create this family tree with the political thread that runs through their family, that creates both their bringing them together and at times splitting them apart.
And what's so nice about the way it's designed, I think it's brilliant, is this idea of we always see them, they're always lit. And so what you get from that is this sense of while the immediate action is going on and taking place, this is always something that's in the back of their minds, is always
exactly
with them. As they go through their everyday lives, the idea of that uncle back there with his family and their ideas and ideals, that we're carrying that along with us. We never completely let go of it. And it works so effectively. It's lit so well. And so you really do get a sense of that, that these people are never alone. They're never acting independently, that they're always acting, but it's always with the influence of what came behind them and some of the political ideas that came along with it. And it gives just a wonderful resonance to the play. Well, I think this play in particular, what is of most value is you can use this as a starting point to look at any point in history, and as we look back on it, see the extent to which the way we think of it has changed based on what's happened today. It is impossible to think of McCarthyism in the way that we think of it without now thinking of 9/11, even though this play is purposefully set in 1999 before 9/11, and yet now as a modern audience looking at it, you look at that with a certain amount of naivete and to say, well, you know, there is not so much a justification for why the McCarthy hearings occurred, but certainly an understanding and an appreciation of how you could get to that point. And so I think that's ultimately the real value in it, is that families have to figure out a way to get along and reconcile these differences, because history is always going to change the way we view them.